Didn't expect to see you here so early. This is how, as a programmer, I automate my morning. Write a script to get dressed. Yeah, there, that's better. I need some coffee. I can just write a script for that, right? Yeah, there we go. Ooh, perfect temperature too. All right, all in a day's work. Hey friends, welcome back to my video. As you know, I love to automate everything from workflows to my morning to anything I can. I try and automate it. It's the programmer in me. I'm inherent to it. And today we are going to do just that. You know, I love Logitech products. I've been using them for years now. You've seen them in all my coding tutorials. And I recently picked up the new MX Keys S Combo and I've been chef's kiss. Loving it. Mainly, or one of the main things that I've really been loving is the smart actions that I've been creating with them. These are smart actions that you can literally customize your workflow from pressing certain buttons on your keyboard or your mouse, whatever you choose to do, and it will open up, say, your terminal or specific URLs. You can customize it to whatever you want. I literally have a smart action to pull code from a repository for me. And today, we are going to go through some of my favorite smart actions that really help automate my workflow when it comes to productivity, comes to coding, and just everything, life. And in turn, I get a lot of time back. Let's get automating.
All right, morning setup. This is the most important setup, if you ask me. Other than, of course, the one thing that is yet to be automated, I'm sure it will be soon, I just need to invent it, is injecting coffee into my veins. But until then, that's okay. You know, at least we can automate the coffee maker. More important though, you can see here on screen, I have up my Logi Options Plus, and then also too, you can add a device. I already have my two devices connected though. Also too, I really like, as a side note, you can see how much battery is left in each or energy is left in each, because I'm always guilty of leaving it till last minute. If you go up into the right-hand corner, you can see here Smart Actions. And when I click on it, you can see here, I already set up a morning setup, but I erased my other setups and I'm gonna modify this one because I really wanna show you how I set up or automate my workflow. All right, so let's start by going into templates. And this was a great place for me to start because it really shows some examples of preset templates that you can use. And I mean, it's super important and key to customize them, but this is a great place to start if you're like, I don't know what I want. I don't even know what I want to automate yet. So you can scroll through here and see some of them. One that is really interesting too, of course, is reply with ChatGPT. Pull project changes, which is super useful and we'll dive into in a bit here. Open URLs, and then also too, you can create right from scratch. So for my first one though, for morning setup, I'm actually going to go to manage where the one that I created is already set up. And let's go to here, click on it. And what I have set up right now is the if, and this is really, I love how they set this up because it's very, programmer focus, meaning there's that if this happens, then do this. Kind of like in code, if else statements. So it's super easy to use. Clearly I have not had enough coffee yet. So if we go into my if statement, this is how I set it up. In my mouse here, you can see right now I have the back button because it's super, it's just, I did what is user and intuitive to me, what I can easily remember. So I clicked on back button to start with. And then for the keyboard, I did the brightness, the morning setup, the brightness key. And the reason I did this was because it looks like a sunshine and it's the morning. So let's go confirm trigger. Now right now what I have is if those two, that sequence is set in motion, so the back button and then the brightness button, what will happen is Google Chrome will open up. Now, I do want some other things in my morning routine to open up. So let's go into application and you can see here all the applications that I have. So let's scroll down a bit to Visual Studio Code. There we go. And once again, you can see, do you want to bring it to the foreground, close? There's many different things you can do with these applications. So I like how it's very customizable. In this case, I want to open the application, confirm. So once this sequence is in motion, it will open Google Chrome for me, and it will also open the application for Visual Studio Code. Now, when I'm starting my morning, I would say, well, let's scroll. Let's see if there's anything else I typically do. Those are usually the main two things that I need opened, but let's go back to that. See what else, if there's anything else I can think of. I don't usually open the terminal first thing, so we don't need that. Let's do, I think that's a good way to kind of start my morning, is simple, to the point, having those two applications set up. All right, so let's put this into motion. So picture this, going back to, I wake up first thing in the morning, get my coffee, come into the office, and then after I do these two sequences of the back button and then the brightness button, I automate my workflow. Let's try it out. Confirm. All right, so I'm gonna press the back button, followed by the brightness button, and you can see here it opened up in the other tab, my other screen, but these two, you can see now my Google Chrome opened up in the background here, and then the forefront, which is my VS Code. So this is super user friendly, and it just makes it such a fun way to kind of start your day. Okay, next up is code time. I think that's what I'm calling it anyways. I don't know if that's actually a term, but it's code time. And for this, you know, I've already had my morning kind of set up. I usually do a bit of meetings in the morning, also to responding to emails. So then by mid-morning, early afternoon, I can focus on writing some code. So in templates again, I'm going to actually start this time with, let's start with open URLs, because I want to open a specific URL. So I'm going to start with this template and then modify it to my own personal. So let's go if. Adding the trigger is always the most hardest thing to do, in my opinion. It's kind of like when you're naming a variable. It's like, okay, what do I do? It's like the simplest application or the simplest actions are always the most difficult. So let's do forward because we're forward thinking. And on the keyboard, I'm gonna do mute because when I'm coding, I need it to be quiet. I need peace. So forward, mute. I like that. This is tiffintech getting creative here. So the first thing I wanna do is bring up GitHub. And I actually was thinking when I was customizing this, I was like, what URL do I want to open in GitHub? Is it my, like a specific project, or is it my profile? But I'm actually just gonna do github.com. I'm always logged into it. And the reason for that is because I not only have my personal GitHub or my personal projects on GitHub, but I also have my work projects on, like my day job on GitHub as well. So I wanted to be kind of generic that I see the feed, and also to, well, let's just pull it up here. So this is what I want to open up. So you can see here my top repositories. I also can see some trending repositories, recommendations, and then two, I have my stack bit, which is where I work, and I can open up that as well. So let's copy this, copy and close actually. Now let's go into our then. So bring to the foreground Google Chrome, so it'll be the first thing that we see, which yes. And then after a 3-second delay, we will have a new browser tab, and then we will open up, right now it's Logitech.com, we want to change that to GitHub.com. And then I also, well, right now they have another one, which is gmail.com. And for this, actually, I want to open up one of my favorite websites right now. It's called daily.dev. Highly recommend you check it out. It's really cool. They always have like trending stories. I love it. All right, so let's go confirm. And let's see. This is good. So this is to start with. I think that feels good. All right, so now let's do it. So we go forward, mute. And you can see here, it opened up GitHub. And then a few seconds later, it opened up Daily Dev. So this is really great. And it's super simple, kind of getting into the, there is something about routine. When you are doing a routine, you have a routine, it just makes you feel like your mindset gets in the zone. I'm sure there's studies on this actually. I should include some stats here around it, but this is a great way.
All right, I hope you enjoyed going through this video, automating some of my life, well, more so my workflow with me. It is so fun. I just think being able to really customize your actions and your workflow is so key to success. And I know it sounds kind of silly, like, you know, having these tasks for smaller tasks like opening your browser, but the significance in having a routine when you are doing this, when it's the same URL opens every day, the same app opens all the time, it really is the consistency part of it that is so huge as well. Not only from a time-saving aspect, but also to just getting in the rhythm. It's one of those things that when you do, when you do the same kind of set of actions day in and day out, your brain knows is triggered as to what's going to happen. For example, before I typically start work, as you know, this is my home office, I work from home, I'll always make sure to get out in the morning, whether it be to a workout class, whether it be for a walk. But that is key for me because it tells my brain, okay, this is kind of the rhythm and flow we are going to get into for the day. It doesn't just start by walking into my office. Same kind of thing when I use these smart actions. It's not just something that I use once in a while. I use them every day to be consistent. And then also to, especially with the coding ones, the coding setup ones, when I do those smart actions, it just kind of gets my mindset into the frame of, okay, now is focus time, now is coding time. I linked the MX keyboard and mouse down below in the description, so make sure to go check them out. And if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button, give this a like, and I'll see you all soon. Let me know what else you can automate. I want to hear all the smart actions you automate with. Okay, bye everyone.